Yay, hello, hello, and welcome to this week of Magnet Marketers. It's Training Tuesday Live. Our goal is always to help you become a magnet with your marketing versus being a bullhorn. And today, I'm excited for our topic. We're going to talk about building connections through conversation on Instagram and just the power of that, the power of connections that can be built there. And we have a special guest to talk about that today, Erin Sell. But before we introduce our special guest, just a quick hello, hello, if we've not met before. My name is Jessica Phillips with Now Marketing Group and the Relationship Marketing System. And my awesome co-host, he's Mike Gingrich. He's president of the web development and software firm Digital Hill Multimedia, published author of five times over. Books. I mean, he just keeps writing them. I don't know. Like, he's just a powerhouse like that. Triathlete, runner, biker, and leading business blogger at MikeGingrich.com. That's his new bio. I'm going to try to memorize it by next time. Mike, I love it. How are you?
Hey, thank you. Thank you. And well done, Jessica. Thank you. And I have the privilege to introduce Erin a little bit further here today. So we have Erin Sell with us, and she is operating Socially Powered. You probably find them online. She's a social media strategist, consultant, speaker, passionate about helping businesses understand the power of social media, which is what we're all about. And that's why she's here. She's helped thousands of business owners, entrepreneurs, executives improve their online presence while saving them time and money, which is important to all of us. And so we're looking forward to kind of diving in and hearing some golden nuggets of wisdom from Erin today. Welcome, Erin.
Welcome. Thank you. Thank you guys for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Yeah. Where are you joining in from?
I'm actually in snowy Denver, Colorado.
Oh, wow.
Snowy. Wow.
Yes. I'm not ready for it. I say that every year. I live in Ohio. You'd think I'd learn. But speaking of where we're all at, I see we have Amy with us today. Hello, Amy. Let us know where all of you are joining in from. Also, Aid, I think hopefully I said that right. Let us know where you are joining in from. And also, are you using Instagram to build connections through conversation? So, Erin, you and I kind of go back to social media marketing world. We talked about, I was on your podcast. We were talking about, you know, building connections and how a lot of it is starting in the DMs, right? Like that was kind of our conversation around just using Instagram. And I follow you on Instagram. And I think you do a phenomenal job there making connections. And that's the goal for having you on today. Yeah, you do. You're just, I love when you can meet someone and follow them on social media first, right? Like that's where we connected first, of course, before in real life. Yep. And meet them and say, this is exactly how I thought you would be in real life. You know, that's how you know you've really stood out and made this impact. But I know, like Mike said in your bio, you've helped thousands of businesses kind of do just that with some best practices. And you've done this with a focus on Instagram. So can you tell us a little bit about some of your best tips for brands, even like getting started using Instagram and why and how they can start this process off?
Yeah. And so I think it, like, let's back up just a little bit, because I think it's important to know partially why or how we connected was because of your social media week, my social media day. And that's really how I started like connecting with people on Instagram, was because of events. And it doesn't necessarily have to mean live events, because I mean, we all know right now live events are not happening. But you know, you can still connect with people like you're doing here. You know, I know you just recently did a summit. You know, Agora Pulse is doing all kinds of summits. There's all kinds of things happening online, and all of these tips and tricks can be used for the online or in-person events. So basically, I mean, what I always say with Instagram, and I know you'll agree with this, Jessica, because everything goes down in the DMs, the direct messages, but you need to start that conversation before you move into the DM. So my first thing I always say is really do your research into the companies that you want to connect with and make sure that they are the right people and they have the same type of audience that you're looking to connect with further. So first thing you want to do is obviously go do your research, but then go like their Instagram page and or, I mean, honestly, like all these tips aren't necessarily only used for Instagram. You can use them for Facebook, LinkedIn, whatever platform you're working with. I primarily, Instagram is my favorite, so that's why I focus there. But first thing you want to do is go follow them, and then you want to start interacting with their page. Go like some posts, go comment on a few posts, you know, reply to other people that are commenting on their posts. And once you've done that and you're starting to, you know, I guess, interact and engage with them on the main feed, then you can potentially take it to the DM. And the way that you want to do that is by ideally having a reason to take it to the DM. So if you see something on their page that you can, you know, go start that conversation with them in the direct messages, then that's what you want to do.
Which I feel like you actually just said, even before you said knowing who you want to connect with and then finding out who they are, right, and connecting with them, you actually said something powerful before that, that I really think it's so simple, but it's often missed, is that you knew what you were using the channel for. Your whole goal was, hey, I want to connect with people for the purpose of, you know, building my event and in connecting with other people doing events. Like, that was your purpose. And I feel like when you solidify that ahead of time, then it really helps you kind of plan in who do I want to connect with first. And it seems so like simple, right? But often that can be the difference that like creates your feed to be sporadic or very intentional then with who you're connecting with. And
I definitely think that that is super important, is to, you want to make sure that the people that you're connecting with are the people that you want to reach for whatever it is that you're doing. So one of the things that, you know, everything goes back to social media day for me, and I'm sure you do this as well, but I mean, I was looking for people that are active locally. So for example, one of the things that I was looking for was food. And so I wanted to do food trucks, because then you can get a variety of food and you're not stuck with like one menu. Yeah. And, you know, especially when you're doing events, you never know what people are, if they're vegan or vegetarian or gluten-free or whatever. So you want to have different options, right?
Right.
So that was one of the things that I did was, and I just loved it because I found these people, you know, I looked to see, are they active on social media? Are they actively, you know, posting and communicating with people? And then I reached out and was like, hey, you know, I'm doing this event. I'd love to connect with you, see how we can work together. And from there, once I started that conversation, I was even, they would do intros to me to other people that, and then it's not just you reaching out like blindly, you know, it's like the cold call, right? Yeah. And so then they were doing the intros for me. So I didn't even have to, I didn't even have to do the work. They did it for me, and it worked out great because I was able to get multiple trucks there. They were friends, like they, you know, worked together. So that was just one example. And I have many, many more. If you guys want them.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Might you have any question to that first? Cause I have like three, like right at the back, but go ahead first.
So the other ones that I have is for events, and I always like to do giveaways, and I always say this about you, Jessica, is that you're like the queen of prize, like not prizes, but presents and giveaways and really like going above and beyond. So whenever I do my event, we always do some sort of prizes and giveaways. And so I'm always looking for stuff that is relative or, you know, goes along with whatever we're talking about. So, you know, for example, we had Agora Pulse at, they were like our main sponsor at our last event. And so they, of course, gave a discount, you know, they gave like a free, I think it was like a free month of service. But then I've also worked with other companies that have actual, you know, physical products. And one of them was that we did was Get Rocket Book or Rocket Book. So it's like the book you write in, and then it can upload to like Google Docs or Dropbox or wherever it is you want to go. So it was something that
you can actually find your notes after you take them.
Right. Yeah. So it was one of those things that I personally wanted because I was like, oh, this is really cool. Right. Cool.
Yeah.
And so I reached out to them and surprisingly, you know, they wrote me back and they're like, yeah, sure. We'll donate. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get enough for everybody that in attendance, but they at least gave me enough of those that I was able to give them to my speakers and sponsors of the event. So, and then, you know, do some giveaways and all that. So that's, you know, another example of
giving people something to talk about. Julie says, love my rocket books, but I want to like, I love that. So one, you said, you know, connecting with people and you're not just going straight into the DM and going for the ask. Like I've started noticing that unfortunately on Instagram and kind of LinkedIn had been notorious for it, still kind of is, with people just going connection and then straight into the pitch, right? But you had said, don't, you know, start engaging first and then have a reason for messaging into these profiles to start the conversation, not the ask, and then give people something to talk about, you know, that's related to them, something that they're going to want to share and be craveable. But I have one question for you too, before your next tip, because this is gold. I love these ideas, but just so someone knows, if they're not familiar with searching on Instagram, like how did you go about, because you said I was looking for food trucks, right? Like, and I was looking for people that were local. Like what was your process? Do you use a tool or do you use some native things built in Instagram?
You know, I just did a search in Instagram. Mm-hmm. You know, it was hashtag Denver food truck. And then I went through and looked at who was posting, you know, who actually was posting a fair amount. Because, I mean, a lot of times I feel like, you know, somebody can be, maybe they have social media, but they're not actually active. They're not really using it.
Right.
So I wanted people that understood that social media was important and being active was even more important. So, because otherwise you're trying to talk to people that don't understand it and it doesn't have value for them. Mm-hmm. And so that was my biggest thing. Another thing that I did was I love this story because I went to an in-person event when we still had in-person events.
Remember
and so it was a wine tasting event and there were two wineries that are here local. I'm actually a member of one of them and had been for many years, but they had this event and it was held at the one place and then another winery came in. And as I'm talking to the owners of the two wineries, it was, gosh, I think it was like a month before my event. And I was looking for somebody to donate wine for the event. And so we start talking and I'm like, oh, well, I can help you. So I helped them with their Instagram accounts. I helped, like I gave them tips and ideas for things that they could do to improve on their Instagram. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, well, if you want more, you can come to my event and I'm really looking for, you know, somebody to provide wine. And so they did. And so I was lucky that, you know, they were able to come and get value, like send their employees to learn more about Instagram and, you know, all the social media stuff. Mm-hmm. But then they were also able to be there to promote their brand and, you know, talk about it to everybody who was attending. So it was win-win. Yeah.
I love that. I love that story because the big takeaway from it, whether it's an event that you're doing or not, is that you're adding value first. And that's kind of the common thread that you've mentioned here throughout, right? Like finding a common core purpose that maybe both you guys have, something in common, connect with them, engage with them, learn about them, and then build upon that relationship and then add mutual value before you're asking for value back. So I love that. First of all, wine, like, yes, winning. Second of all, like that you're helping them. You weren't just asking for a donation and you're giving them now a platform to shine. Like real quick, similar Instagram, completely different story, but just something so that anybody can do, right? Like, so we work with a client that, you know, has a brick and mortar store, but they're also selling online and they locally are really selling to more geographic specifically around Ohio. So I was looking for promoting small business, you know, Shop Small, Small Business Saturday, right. And just searched out because I was like, do you have some other relationships with local businesses that you'd want to promote for Shop Small? And they were like, not really, that has our same demographic. So I did the same thing. I started searching first because they're trying to, they have like a candy store that also sells some like craft items, things like that. So I searched online first for other local Ohio craft store suppliers and then found their Instagram and looked through their Instagram.
You're doing that search on Google first?
I went to Google first, yeah, actually. Okay. I didn't know the businesses yet, yeah. Right? And just searching Ohio could have taken a little bit longer. And so I looked for specific like name types of company on Google first, then checked them out. And then found some of these brands that I live in Ohio I'd never heard of, but they were crushing it on Instagram. So I connected with them, looked at who they were engaging with. Yep. It took me maybe an hour, okay? But these brands, then we're preparing this post to say, hey, we understand, you know, it's going to look a lot different shopping this weekend. But we want to encourage you to shop small, shop safe, you know, and shop, you know, with some specialties, like some niche things that you may not find just on Amazon that's out there. And so all these brands are like really craft come almost like Etsy shops, but they had stores online. So we're tagging them, but they have thousands more followers than the client that's just getting started, but we're mentioning them when we started building this relationship. So now that's going to start that relationship building too, to give like them a shout out. It's now going to, you know, help the audience in a way, because it's like, hey, here's how you can shop small and some fun stores that you can shop right from home, that things you may not have heard of. Right. And now it's in enhancing the reach of the client at the same time. So maybe they're not getting a monetary give back right now out of it, but it is giving them exposure, relationship building, which will then in turn in future kind of create more of an ROI. So however you're doing this, I love what you're saying, Aaron. These kinds of tips can be used for all things. It's just making that connection first and then, you know, see what can come out of it.
Yeah. From there. No, I agree. And so one of the other things that we did was we went after influencers. Mm-hmm. In the, like, that were, say, bloggers or photographers or whatever that had a large audience, that the majority of their followers were also located in Denver. So a lot of the ones that we went after were like food bloggers, because they were going to different restaurants mm-hmm. around Denver. And so it was like a win-win. And so we offered them free tickets to the event, which is something, you know, that's super easy to do. And mm-hmm. so in exchange, they promoted the event to all of their followers. And, you know, we gave them a special offer so that they get, you know, they gave all their followers a discount to the event. They got free tickets. They got to do, we actually even did like a giveaway so they could give away. So that mm-hmm. somebody could actually right. join them at the event and like meet them in person, because, you know, that's also kind of a fun way, you know, if you want to meet your favorite yeah. Instagram star.
And are you connected with these brands after the event now? So you're building this community. And I love that.
Especially like the winery. I go back to that because that's one of my favorites. But, you know, every time I go up there to grab my wine or whatever, I always make sure to post and tag them and be like, come visit. If I'm, you know, anything else that I'm using, I mean, I actually am bad. I got that Rocket Book and then I didn't use it as much as I should have. But yeah, definitely. If I see like the food truck out and about, I still post about it. So it's the, I guess, longevity of it, because you're able to continue talking about those businesses and still, you know,
able and should like look at this as a community, right? Like yeah. you've now created this mutually giving relationship and bond where it's business is supporting business. And I feel like that sometimes building the community aspect is one of the most underutilized things that we as brands do. We think like we got to do this all on our own. And just by supporting and giving a shout out to someone else or helping them out in a way, everything you give out is always going to come back tenfold. But yeah, building that community, I mean, you're stronger in numbers, one, and two, it lets people see like, oh, there's this tribe going on. Like, I want to be part of that. It's like this connection with others, you know?
So another tip or trick that I have is I actually used LinkedIn for some of my search. And what I did was I kind of worked backwards. Like, I knew, for example, PopSockets is here in Colorado. They're a Boulder company. OtterBox is also a Colorado company. Unfortunately, it didn't work out for either of those to actually do a partnership with. But what I did was I went to LinkedIn, put in the company, went to see if I had any connections, and I did. So I reached out to them. I did that via LinkedIn, but that's also another option for you. Mm-hmm. Is, you know, see if you have a connection. If even if you don't have a first degree connection, you may have a second. Mm-hmm. And if so, then maybe you can ask somebody for an intro. But it did end up working out for me for one thing. And I know, Jessica, you and I have talked about this in the past, and that is, it's how I got my venue. Mm-hmm. I was connected to a professor, a marketing professor at Metro State. Mm-hmm. And I reached out to her and was like, hey, I know it didn't work out for us to do something last year, but I'd love to, you know, discuss and see mm-hmm. if we can make something happen this year. And then it ended up, after we had conversations, it ended up that they were my venue. And so wonderful. It was, I mean, that was one of my objectives always with Social Media Day, was giving back to the community and mm-hmm. providing education, you know, within Denver. And so it was just the perfect partnership, because not only did they give us a space to have the event, they also provided us with all these student volunteers to help, you know, make the event go off, and in exchange, you know, we did student tickets, and then all the volunteers got to attend the event. So it was a win-win there.
I love that.
Yeah.
Excellent. Yeah.
Do you have any questions yet, Mike? I don't want to jump in. I'm like, love
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no, I think, I mean, what I've heard is, has been really good. You know, you can do hashtag searches, obviously. Mm-hmm. And then Jessica mentioned Google, you know, as an option there. And then you came back to LinkedIn as a way all to kind of find that right audience. Yep. And then, kind of coming back to, you know, I always think about it with Instagram, come back to Instagram, you know, and there's kind of to kind of build that rapport when they don't know you. You can kind of do that two ways. Number one, everyone likes positive engagement. So on their regular posts, right, you can comment, you can say, hey, love that type of thing. And they love that, because that's a, you know, the rest of the world is seeing it. They got a positive comment, that type of thing. And then, you know, as well, stories are a little more intimate. And so then, you know, by giving a positive comment on a story of theirs, you know, that's almost kind of beginning a DM, a personal little conversation there. But that's all before, that's just kind of, you know, looking for ways to be positive, be helpful, be kind. And that kind of establishes a little bit of rapport, I think, ahead of time that can be valuable, you know, down the pike when you want to engage further.
Definitely.
Yeah. And I love that everything we've mentioned, because there is tools like Hashtagify, which I'll put in the comments here, that will help you find the right hashtags for a search maybe you're looking for, and the influencers for those, right? But I love that you didn't mention a dang tool, because, like, I firmly believe, I say this all the time, it's not about the tool you're using, it's about your technique, and that you're using all free native tools first to do kind of that research, and starting with the connections that you already know, because I can bet you a ton of money that you didn't start those LinkedIn connections a week before your event, right? Like, it's not something that you can automate and still get the same result with just, hey, I'm going to connect with someone and immediately go into this pitch or have the bots doing the comments, because there's a ton of tools that will do that.
Right.
But it's not going to work the same way as if a human is doing it thoughtfully with clarity, conviction of who they're trying to connect with and to build that relationship.
Yeah. And I definitely, I mean, one of the things I did in addition was, like, on LinkedIn, if I didn't have a connection with somebody, I mean, you know, Jessica, because you plan events too, but you don't, you start planning that event months and months in advance. And right. Yeah. And so, I mean, I was like 3 months, 6 months, whatever, I was reaching out to people that I wanted to be connected with. One of them, that stands out to me was media. Like, I really wanted media coverage. And so I had a few connections here and there that I reached out to. But that was, I just went on LinkedIn and again, you know, typed in Nine News or Fox News, Denver, whatever it was, and looked to see where those, I already had those connections. And if I didn't have the connections, then I typically would send them a message, you know, like, hey, I'm Erin. I'm planning this event. I would love to see how to get you involved. And I definitely never start with an ask. It's always like, mm-hmm. Would you be interested in being a part of this event?
Yeah. So, it's a lot different when you're getting a personal message versus just a blanket kind of PR, you know, press release into your email with kind of to whom it may concern kind of thing. Right. You know, like people are going to be more amped to respond that way than if it's directly coming from a real human. Oh, don't worry. I got my kids.
So I have the smallest dog ever, and he has the loudest bark.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. But so we talk a lot about events. And like you said, it's not just in-person events. It can be online events like Agora Pulse. You mentioned them, you know, reaching out and they're hosting, you know, several events throughout the year. They just did a phenomenal Twitter one. They had LinkedIn before that, and it was a free summit. In order to provide it for free, they had to build their community that was also willing to help serve in that purpose, right? So they're reaching out to others that are willing to help, you know, provide then their time and their attention and their sharing of what the event is. So you can do this even no matter what industry you're in. Think about what can I give back and what can I do to, you know, show up for the community in a way that's going to support others and help build that relationship and reach out to people that way. Yep. Or even if you're a business like the Small Business Saturday example, to grow kind of your community that way, or even if it's just a blog and building like your search engine optimization and your relationships that way. We've used Instagram that way for clients too, in saying like, okay, we want to provide some stellar value, because we all know the only way to get to the top of Google is to answer a question better than anyone else if you want to do it organically. And the best way to do that is bring in the best of the best who knows the answer to that question and feature them, because one, you're going to have the relevancy for what the answer is, and then the authority because people are sharing it out. So if you can provide relation or create those connections. So like example, a real estate company that we wrote a blog on selling your home faster, and faster, you know, what you needed to do. And we brought in asked home stagers and, you know, home inspectors, what people are looking for in order to build that authoritative post, but we're featuring others in it that have some good exposure. So it doesn't matter if you're doing an event, a blog, if you're creating some kind of just online challenge, we've seen that online. Right. The whole goal is building that community and bringing people in. So this advice I think could be taken through no matter what your end goal is at the end of the day.
Agreed. And I mean, I think we all know this, but I think the most important thing is to always be thinking about what it is you're giving back to your people. Like, it's not about you, it's about them.
Absolutely. So like, I know, I mean, I could talk about this all day, but like, what are some things, just with that being said, of just please avoid, or these things don't have, you know, good endings to it if you try this out, just things to avoid overall?
Well, I mean, I definitely think the don't go in like trying to sell them on something. Don't be pushy. If they say no, say thanks. And, you know, can I check in with you again next year, maybe, or in a few months? Don't get down on yourself if people are saying no, because I had so many people say no to me. It was, I waited too long. They already spent their budget. They already this, they already that. You know, there were tons and tons of reasons why people didn't want to participate for whatever, you know, whatever it was. But you have to just keep looking and you'll find the right partnership or company or a person or whatever it is that you're looking for.
I love that. And I'm sure like I've went through the same thing with doing the event, you know, the first year or whatever, right? Like people are like, what's your event? What are you doing? Right? Like, I don't know about that, you know, not really wanting to jump all in until they seen what it was about.
Right.
And that's okay. But I still maintain the relationship with them. I didn't take their no as, okay, I'm going to stop talking with you, because then it shows face, right? Like what you're really in it for, that you were just in it for you. Same thing goes if they said yes. And that's the only thing that you did was take from them. And then they don't hear from you again until the year of your event or whatever it is.
Right.
Make sure whoever you're building that community with, it sounds like, I mean, you do this well too, is being intentional about it and consistent with it. So it is a partnership and it's not always about an ask, but it is about mutually kind of, I'm there for you, kind of you show up for me, and we're going to support each other along the way, no matter if it's a yes 1 year or a no 1 year, that you're intentional about it. I like that.
And I think you'll be surprised that it almost always comes back to you in some way, shape, or form. I've had that happen so many times that, you know, it's, you meet that person, you have that conversation, and then years later, maybe it comes back to you and you're like, oh my gosh, how did, like, I actually a client of mine that we talked, I gave her something, years later she comes back to me and she's like, Erin, can you help me with, you know, my Instagram marketing? And you know, we still, it's like, how did we even meet? So you never know how it will come back to you if you, like you said, you know, are giving and not always doing the take.
Yeah. Julie said the same thing. She said, yes, having done events, you know, and getting sponsors and partnerships, the no's will definitely happen. You cannot take them personally. They are still worthy of keeping a relationship, because chances are they're probably still going to share it or talk about it regardless. Like we said, things go down in the DMs, you know, how you're treating someone else, that's going to be the reputation tone that they're going to pass along. So regardless, even if somebody says no to you, still keep it positive, right? And still stay connected, because you're still building your brand credit, if you will, culture credit overall. And Jacqueline says 100% come back for all the good things that you put out. That goes for everything. Amen to that.
Yep.
Yeah.
I agree.
This is awesome, Erin. So I do, as you know, Mike, I want to open up any additional questions, last questions that you have. But Erin, in the meantime, where can people find you online to connect with you and learn more about?
Super easy. It's everywhere at Socially Powered. My website, sociallypowered.com. And I was going to say, I was looking to see what your show was, and you were on episode 14.
You have a phenomenal show. She's talking about it is a podcast that she does, and it is phenomenal. It was so much fun. My face hurt by the end of it because I was smiling and laughing so much. But it's just storytelling, as you are in everything that you do. It's just effortless, real you, but so many like great nuggets of value when you're doing things the right way, which I love. So I can't wait to go to your event in Denver. I'm hoping that everything comes back, of course, next year. We don't know what things are going to look like, but regardless, I know you're doing some amazing things online and adding value there. So thank you for that. I'll put the link in the comments here and also in our blog.
Everybody should go listen to your podcast because it was so good.
Aw. She's so sweet. Mike, any last questions on your end?
Erin, I think, you know, final question, maybe you referenced that winery a number of times. That's kind of become a favorite of yours. Then, you know, what was a tip that you gave them that you, you saw them implementing that was helpful for them? You know, let's take it down to a winery level.
Well, the main thing that I always is your bio and where you're sending people. Like, look at your bio. Is it enticing? And theirs was, I think they had like one line. They didn't really say like who they are. And I think that's really important. Another thing that I also say with bios is include hashtags. And don't, like, if your username, I'm just going to call them out because I love them. So it's Balistrary, which is not that easy to spell, but they're, you know, it's Balistrary Winery. You don't necessarily, they probably would in this case because it's a winery, but for example, me, I'm at Socially Powered, but in my description, not, you know, that at Socially Powered, but in my description, it's, I don't know what it says exactly, but it's something about like social media marketing, right? Mm-hmm. Because mm-hmm. You don't know what Socially Powered is, yep. But then in my description, if I say I help with social media, right? Mm-hmm. And then in your bio, you can go into more detail and kind of give like your differentiators. So, you know, you might want to say like, I'm a Denver-based social media marketing mm-hmm. that really likes to help with Instagram. Or mm-hmm. something along those lines. So then people know what it is that they're getting from your page. You want to, you know, if you're providing food tips or whatever it is, like be descriptive and tell people what to expect from you. So I think
I love that. Good, good, good.
I love that. And the use of hashtags, of course, on there. I mean, that's why it's so important. People are searching essentially for what you have to offer. So you want to make sure that it's related and something not just generic, but something that is related to what your audience could be searching to find you.
Yeah, I agree. And like for the winery, like they should have in there like hashtag Denver winery. That way, if people are coming to Denver, they're wondering what to do. They're like, oh, I like wine. It'd be fun to go to a winery. They can potentially find you by that hashtag.
Yeah, things to do in Denver. You know, look and see what's popular. Again, you can use a tool like Hashtagify to find out which ones are being used, or just look at Instagram. They tell you how many people are using specific hashtags. So look there, use some of those free tools. And just a quick alert, Instagram is also adding search within the descriptions itself. So even what you're writing on each of your posts also kind of come at it from the thought of what I'm writing, is it descriptive of what I'm trying to convey? Because it could now be searchable on Instagram. So just giving you lots more ways of being found. I love it. And I think it's just a powerful app for connection and conversation when used correctly, because, you know, picture speaks 1,000 words and stories speak even more. And, you know, giving people an insight of who you are, what you're all about, can be really powerful to tell your story faster and build those connections. So love it. Thank you so much, Erin, for all your wealth of information. We'll definitely be recapping this with a blog on nowmarketinggroup.com/blog tomorrow to have all Erin's nuggets and more ways of connecting with her. And also go check her out on Instagram, Socially Powered. You can see how she's getting things done and some great connections that she's made as well to get some ideas for your brand. So thank you all for joining in with us this week. It is Thanksgiving here in the U.S. this week. So I do want to say that I'm thankful for all of you tuning in and keeping up with us in the show. Next week, we will have a special episode for you. We're going to be doing predictions in social media and online marketing for 2021. So we'll have some special guests kind of rapid fire in and out next week. So it's an episode you do not want to miss. We'll get that link out to you shortly. Until then, have a happy holiday week and enjoy some time with those you care about and eat some good food in the U.S. And even if you're not in the U.S., eat it anyway. All right, you guys. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Erin.
You're amazing. See you guys.
Well, good night. See ya.